Hey Star Wars fans, FlyGuy from FlyGuy.net with another HD widescreen review of this Bossk from Sideshow. This is pretty cool. We'll take you through and we'll give you a look at this, the articulation and everything else included, and let you see whether this is really worth your dollars or not, or pounds or yen or euros, whatever. Scum and Villainy is the theme that Sideshow have for this. We've seen that obviously all the bounty hunters in that line before. I have to say the image on the front of the box doesn't really do it justice. I think it's the colouring, it's a little bit dark. It's actually a pretty cool figure. This is the Sideshow exclusive, which really was only $10 more. Came with an extra head, basically a snarling Bossk rather than the standard kind of one we see there. So it's the side of the box. On the back, a little bit of Bossk from the movies, very briefly. You can see a couple of bits and pieces of him. This famous snarling part in the movie and his toes. So 6 scale, usual 12 inch. Nothing else to really show you on this guy. Inside the box, we've got the usual kind of thing from Sideshow as well. We've got some text there on screen. Hopefully you can see that. It's really all pretty boring, I have to say. And on we go. If you want to freeze that there, you can read more about Bossk, but it's nothing you won't know. Well, in actual fact, one thing I didn't know was his name, when in Trandoshan, it translates to devours his prey, but I think I do remember actually reading that in the Tales of the Bounty Hunters book many, many years ago. So that's the box. Inside, there's just a bit of a kind of mustard-coloured Bossk-like background, and that's your Bossk. And that's your Bossk. That's your box. It's the way inside, Bossky box. Inside is this other plastic container, and we have a few bits and pieces in here. Again, the Sideshow exclusive, excuse the noise, comes with this extra head, which we'll give you a look at here. Isn't he beautiful? There you go, put him on top of me. How does that look? Am I Bossk? Does that work? No, sadly it doesn't, but never mind. It's not my favourite sculpt of him, with a snarling tongue, but some of you might like it. I'll show you the one on the figure in just a minute that I've used. But look, we've got a good rendition of Bossk here pretty much on the actual figure itself. Again, I'm not loving this head, but you know, the weathering and the all the scales are there. Kind of reminds me of V in some way, the TV show V. Even though Bossk was out before V, something about this just obviously the lizard-like aspects there. So look, that's the mask. Or the second head, I should say, not the mask, with his tongue there, pierced or cut there, obviously, as lizards probably or snakes would, whatever. Talking a lot of rubbish here. He also comes with two extra feet, which is he's got his toes up. Now, they're really, rather than his toes up there, ready to curl up and put his slippers on, I guess, it's more a case of you can get him in quite a decent pose of him crouching down. And that's really what's that there for, but I guess that could be the little scene from Empire Strikes Back with his toes wiggling in the air, but almost translucent ivory white they are. But again, nice detail again by Sideshow. Something about Sideshow and feet just does not work for me. Clones, figures, it just doesn't work. But anyway, you get two of them and you get two spear hands in the box. The ones that he comes with are just basic, can't hold jack shit. Basically, they're just simple claws. So they are off, and we've got one that actually can hold on to something in his hand. So that's the stuff inside the box. Let's get a look at the figure. Just before we do, usual Star Wars stand. No extra additions on this one, just the usual kind of thing. Nothing kind of to write home about. Star Wars stuff sits under these private parts. If he has any, I guess. I don't know. So here we go. So the sculpt again is loving this head. It's really well done. Again, just really hitting out of the park, I think, in terms for Sideshow. I'd love to see what Hot Toys could do with this. I don't know whether they could do much different, but they certainly have done a good job there on the scales and all the kind of weathering in and out of them. The teeth, it's pretty well done. I do like the kind of side profile of them. It looks a much more Bossk-like appearance. The front, not so sure, but it's still a good looking figure, I have to say. Very, very well done. One teeny tiny flaw, and it's not even a flaw, But Bossk's eyes, from all the prints and the movies that I remember and what I can look back, his black eyes were a little bit smaller than that. They were almost almost like slits in his eyes rather than that kind of wide-sized pupil. But, I'm talking about pupil size. He's getting a little picky. Let's get a look at this weapon, which fits pretty well into his hand. We've got some good weathering on this, and nice kind of detail to give it that gun-like effect. No moving parts as far as I can see on the pistol or the rifle without breaking it, but again, the strap's pretty well put in place, so I'm presuming this is the part that Hot Toys have played in this, because I believe there's no Hot Toys on this at all. Normally you find underneath the bottom of the box is a Hot Toys logo there, and they normally supply the guns, but they haven't in this case. Maybe they have, I don't know. But that's the rifle itself, looking very good, holds on to it pretty well, and that's all he's got. Now, on his body, he has a ton of extra clip-on bits and pieces. Basically, everything you can see here is wire. It's like the kind of plastic wire you get inside figures sometimes, you've got to bend it off. So it's kind of fragile. If you bend that too much, it will come off. The flight suit is a little bit kind of wonky, but it does come off as Velcro, but I've not gone too far to do that. So there are removable parts, such as on the front of his leg, he does have this little mane-like piece here which just clips into his pocket. You can see that just kind of clips on there. Not quite sure what that's all about, but I guess it's a mane or something, but it just slides into his front pocket there. I'll put that back later. He has around his legs 22 of these, and I just left one down to show you, 22 of these little pellets, so they can slide in and out quite easily, but they look the part. His legs, when they arrive, a little bit high up on the knees, so you probably do want to pull that down a little bit gently, just to kind of bring that down, I guess, a little bit in the legs. His trousers seem to have ridden up his legs pretty much. But lots of intricate details. That wire runs all the way around this kind of jump flight suit that he's got. Even on the cable we've got here, the kind of air that he's breathing, whatever it may be. You get to see space helmet, I guess, one day, and that plugs into this suit on the back. And these metallic clips that plug in around the belt there. As you can see, that one's popping up. They just clip back in all the way around his waist, these little pellets, almost, I'm presuming it's ammo. Lots of silver detail, white, black, little tiny bits of silver on that, you can see that on that leg there, so really, really accurate and well done. It's the stitching's fantastic, it's colour accurate, love as usual Bossk's logo on his shoulder, very reminiscent of LED's RSS feeds. But this is a very good figure. At first I was really dubious about the quality and the pictures that we saw from Sideshow. I just didn't feel as if it was hitting it. It's a little bit too doll-like to me. And we did have some issues slightly with IG-80 and Boba Fett. Not big issues, but just slight things. It was just, it was just putting you off a little bit. But he's definitely worth it. Still seems to be some stock available. I bought this from Sideshow directly, but a few resellers are selling it. Not many, I have to say. I think they're all a little bit shy of stocking this guy. So pretty much Sideshow will be your place. Big Bad Toy Store, I believe, might have this slightly cheaper. I think it was $150 from them. Can't remember the price I paid for this exactly, but it wasn't a kick in the pants off that. So lots and lots of detail on them. Stitching superb, paintwork superb, the scales are superb. The legs seem a little odd, I guess, just because of the scales, I guess, and it's kind of hard to make them disappear into the legs when you see that seam there, but it actually does work. Reminds me very much of the Kotobukiya, excellent Kotobukiya statue that I had to get rid of. I just did not have room of it, but it was a beautifully made statue, and this is going to replace it really well in that kind of pose that was beautifully done in that statue. Have a look at the video. I'll try and put that in as a related video for you to look at if you haven't seen it. It's excellent. It's really, really good. Part of me wishes I could never get rid of it, but sometimes you just got it for room, that's just what it's all about. But loving all this detail, all that silver around there, so hopefully you've got a good look at this thing now in high def. You can really get a good close-up look at it, and you're deciding for yourself whether you want to add it to your collection or not. But I would strongly recommend you do. All we need now is Dengar. Please, Sideshow, do an excellent Dengar. The one that Hasbro done in 3 3/4 inches is just stunning. Just do that bigger. That'd be fantastic. And then all we need is four Lom and Zuckus, which we kind of have had four Lom in some ways from Medicom, but hopefully Sideshow will redo them all. And we've got all the Bounty Hunters. Woohoo! So if you like Sideshow and Hot Toy Reviews, we've got another channel called TekSushi.com, TekSushi.com. Also on YouTube, youtube.com/TekSushi. And we review a lot of other hot toys there. Batman, the Avengers, just have a look around here. What else have we got? Joker, oh, Iron Man, Warmonger, lots and lots of stuff, and more coming. So check that out if you want to see this kind of 12-inch-like figure on there. Good friends of ours, DC, review some of his stuff as well. Pirates of the Caribbean, loads of other hot toys on there. So check that out. I would love to hear what you think of this. Are you buying the Bounty Hunters? Is this is Bossk rocking it like a boss for you? Let us know in the comments below or on facebook.com/flyguy.net or on twitter.com/flyguy or hunt for us on Google Plus under FlyGuy. And we'll see you for more reviews soon. Let us know again. Leave a comment below, thumbs up, and we'll see you for more soon. Cheers.